All right, so we understand at this point how to use these decision trees, but this is a class about machine learning, right? So we need to figure out how to make those decision trees happen as a result of processing a set of training data. So it's not clear to me how we're going to make that leap.
Let's see if we can figure it out together. So I'm going to play a game with you, Michael, and if we do the game well, then I think we'll have an idea of what a good algorithm might be for actually building a decision tree. So we're going to play 20 questions. You're familiar with 20 questions?
Right. That's the game where I'm allowed to ask yes-no questions to try to guess something that you're thinking of. And if I take more than 20 of them, then I lose.
Right. Okay. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to think of a thing, and you ask me questions, and I'm going to answer them. And we'll see if you can guess what thing I'm thinking about. Okay. I've got something in my head.
First question, the typical first question, is it animal, vegetable, or mineral? But that doesn't seem like a yes-no question. So is it an animal or like a living creature?
The answer is yes.
All right. Is it a person?
Is it a person? The answer is yes.
Is it a famous person?
Oh. Is it a famous person? That's a deep philosophical question, but I'm going to say yes.
Is it a famous person that we both know in like directly?
Oh, who we both personally know directly? I do not believe so. So the answer is no.
Is it a living person?
Living person? No.
So it's a dead famous person. Is the person famous for, say, being in the music industry?
Ah, the answer is yes.
Did this person live during the 20th century?
The answer is yes.
Is the genre of music that the person was associated with, say, hip-hop or rap?
No.
Is the person a singer?
Singer? Yes.
Male or female? Is the person female?
Person female? No. That's 10 questions, Michael.
Yes, the clock is ticking down, but I feel like I have narrowed it down quite a bit at this point. Did the person die since you've become a professor? So say in the last, how long have you been a professor?
Forever, it sounds like, feels like. Let's see, recent death. And I'm going to say the answer is yes.
Is the person's name Michael?
The answer is yes.
All right, I think I'm onto it. Is it Michael Jackson?
No.
Woo-hoo!
Of course it's Michael Jackson.
All right. Thriller.
Yes, Michael Jackson is the answer.
All right, so that was very fun, and I'm very glad that I was able to solve it. But it's not clear to me how this is going to give us an algorithm for building decision trees.
Okay, so let's think about that for a second. So you asked a bunch of questions, and you asked them in a particular order, right? So here's a question I have for you. Why was the first question you asked me whether it was an animal or not?
Ah, well, it seemed like I needed some way of narrowing down the space. And so I wanted to get as much information out of that question as I could to try to make progress towards figuring out who it actually was.
Right. So animal was the first question, and it was because it narrowed things down. So your goal in asking questions was to narrow the possibilities, right?
Sure. Right, because I only have 20 questions, and then I'm out of it. So if I asked questions like, you know, if I had started with, is it someone named Michael, that would have been really bizarre.
Right, and if the answer was no, it's not clear that it would tell you anything at all. So actually, that's an interesting point. You started with animal. You could have started with Michael. And if I had said yes, that would have told you something. But if I had said no, it wouldn't have told you hardly anything at all. Right? So animal is a better attribute or feature to ask about than Michael as a first question. You agree with that?
Yeah, because it could have been like a stapler or something like that, and then the Michael question would have been pretty silly.
Exactly. So what about person? So first you asked about animal, then you asked about person. Why person?
Right, because again, it seemed like of the space of possibilities that I could think of, person would help kind of, again, narrow things down. That if it was the answer was yes, I would be able to focus there. If the answer was no, I could focus someplace else.
Exactly. And so I think, in fact, we could have a general statement here that each one of these questions, person, famous, do we know this person personally, so on and so forth, all make sense because they further narrow down the possibilities. And that bit about further is important. Because it implies that the usefulness of a question depends upon the answers that you've gotten to previous questions. So even though Michael is not a particularly good first question to ask, it's a perfectly reasonable 12th question to ask, or however far down it is, given that you already know this is an animal, a person, a famous person we don't know personally, who's not living, was into music, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, that makes sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think then we have the hints of an algorithm. So let's try to write down that algorithm and see if it matches with our intuition.